Hello everyone and welcome back to another Infinite Galaxy video. Today I want to talk about flagships. We can now get more flagships from missions. So at daily missions, if you finish the last mission, you can get the secret prototype device box, which can provide random flagship blueprints. As far as I know and heard on Discord, even give you a full flagship at once. Lower chance there for sure. Second, you can get your flagships in campaign. Starting in the early campaign, always on the last stage, you get in the last box some flagship blueprints. You first will get the Nemesis, then in later chapters you will get the Theseus, and I'm pretty sure when you get further there will be more coming. The last source for flagships is coming from, yeah, I would say, let's say it's Alliance events. When you go and clear, that's a little bit slow, hope it doesn't crash. Okay, here we are. When you go and clear these star fields, you do get as reward also flagship blueprints. So, as said, there are now multiple sources to get flagships. Some important things to know: you can buy in the trade center under blueprints flagship blueprints, but only for these flagships that you already built. Blue flagship blueprints are 300 Federation credits. Purple epic are 600 Federation credits. And if you go to legendary gold ones, they are 600 advanced. So that's an important thing. They are advanced Federation credits. Advanced Federation credits you can get from campaign, from events. The standard ones you also get from simulation challenges. These credits, they are gone. So if you buy a blueprint, let's say here for the Hercules, and you use it on the Hercules, it will always stay on the Hercules. There's two things to improve your flagship. You can fortify it. Fortifying a flagship is done with flagship data ships. And it's like adding XP to your flagship, increasing the stats. Modifying a flagship, you do need flagship blueprints. The higher you go, the more flagship blueprints you need. It will increase the flagship stats and it will increase the skills of your flagship. So that's very important because these skills, let's look at the moment at the Argo, this is still level 1. They do have like your crew, they have a starting value, and every time the skill goes up, these values go higher, and they can make a huge difference there. When you want to reset your flagship, you will get back the XP, your flagship goes back to level 1, but you will not get back the blueprints that you put in. So you can only get the XP, switch it to a new flagship. You pay a little bit of Corium for that, but the blueprints, the Federation credits you spend for these flagships, they are gone. Okay, so that were the basics about the flagships. As soon as you get 100 flagship blueprints, you can start building a new flagship, and when you did this, you can buy additional blueprints to level up this flagship, like fortifying it. So the flagships available, it's now already quite a big list. As said before, there are blue rare ones, there are purple epic ones, and there are golden legendary ones. And I now want to switch over to this flagship overview list I made. I will share the link in the description of the video, so you can also access it there. The ID identifies the type of flagship. So let's have a quick look back. Type of flagship. If we do have a look here at the Orion and the Artemis, you can already see based on the design, they look the same. They are the same, just two different tier classes of this flagship. And with this, you will see the values will increase. It's pretty straightforward. Higher tier level, higher values. Tier one, sorry, higher rarity, higher values. Blue rarity, rare ships, they do have 1.8% on their first skill. Epic ones 3% and legendary ones 5%. Just already as like basic information there. Okay, I did put, excuse me if there might be a typo. I had to do this all manually. I do not have the values for the Hercules and the Nemesis as I already leveled these ships up, so I cannot put these values inside there to compare. All other values are for unranked level 1 ships, so you can compare them against each other. I don't think it is critical that I don't have the Hercules and the Nemesis, because you still can compare the legendary version of these ships to all the other ships. Okay, so that's a flagship ID, flagship name, tier. Blue is rare, purple is epic, gold is legendary. Then you have the power, the attack bonus, HP, armor, shield, leadership. The leadership for all flagships starts at 100 and will increase over time when you level up and tier up the flagship damage. Weapon slots. Rare ships do have 4 weapon slots and 3 protective slots. Epic ships do have 4 weapon slots and 4 protective slots. And legendary ships do have 5 weapon slots and 5 protection slots. So that already makes these legendary much better because you can put more modules inside. I personally think because of the currency that you need to level up these flagships. So if I take a look at my Nemesis that already got modified a few times, I now need 900 blueprints to level it up from 7 to 8. And while I do have quite a lot of normal Federation credits, my advanced Federation credits amount is very low. I do think at the beginning of the game, this will be like also with the crew members. Rare and epic ships are probably the best ships to use just because you can buy the blueprints easily. Buying the blueprints for the legendary ships will be pretty difficult if you are not a high money spender. So if you want to whale out and buy these things, that's a different story. Then you easily can level up also legendary ships. But for all the players that are low spend or no spend players, I would stick to rare and epic flagships at the beginning till you can build up enough advanced credits. And till you for sure get the right flagships, the one that you want. The worst thing you can do is invest in a flagship that might not be the perfect one for what you want to do, and then these credits are lost as you can't get them back. So keep that in mind. Let's talk quickly about these different flagships, about the skills. The power and damage seems to go up pretty linear with the rarity, but all of them they do have different skills. And we will now just look at the legendary version of each of these ships because yeah, they are available for all of them and we can easily compare them. I added a note where I think where do these warships shine, where do they have their place in game. Leave me in the feedback, in the comment section, your feedback. Maybe you got a different opinion, or you already were able to try something out and can add some additional information there. So the Prometheus, the big version of the Hercules, gives you with his skill 1 additional missile attack. Skill 2 adds leadership, but the leadership bonus there, the 1755 max, when you already have fortified your flagship to the max, I don't think that this is a big amount. My level 8, or let's take a look, how do we call this? If we look at the Nemesis, modify my rank 8, sorry, my rank 7, level 40 Nemesis, got a leadership boost of 3100. So, adding additional 1700 seems big, but you do get leadership boost also from like your from other skills, from your core modules, from crew members, and very important, from your line. So my total leadership is already 10,000. And we are not talking about the maxed out version of this flagship. And that is why I do think that talking about plus 1755, it's not making the huge difference. Big difference, warship attack only versus neutral units. So if there's like a condition, I made it dark blue, versus neutral units like pirates, you get plus 54% attack. Skill 4 gives you warship armor, warship shield, warship HP. That is good, up to 21.6% for each of them. And skill 5 increases the versus bonus. So I will also quickly show you what is meant with the versus bonus. Where were we? Ah, sorry. Skill 5 is not available on this one. So skill 5. Frigates do have a bonus of 15% versus cruisers, and you can get additional 27%. Destroyers versus frigates, 27%. Cruisers versus destroyers, 27%. So this is like an attack modifier or a damage modifier, but only from one type of warship against another. If we would compare it probably to the warship attack, we may need to divide it by 3 because it only versus 1 out of 3. But it's still a nice bonus. So you got additional attack, and one skill with protection. Good versus pirates, no question. If you want to push versus pirates, this should give you some nice bonus. The Jason and Argo increases the load capacity with skill 1, increases resource gather speed with skill 3, increases warship speed with skill 4, warship armor with skill 5. Two out of the 4 skills are for gathering resources. The load can also help you if you want to farm resources in PvP, but I do see the ship mainly with like your leftover warships to gather resources from asteroids and planets. Athena and Nemesis, flagship attack up to plus 135%. Flagship damage reduction up to plus 94.5% damage reduction ratio, they call it. Convert to damage. So let's quickly show you these also. Then we should be clear there. Here we have Athena. Flagship damage ratio reduction up to 95%. Not exactly sure how that works, but it will reduce the damage your flagship can get. The ratio of battle losses converted to damaged warships in battle, that's especially in PvP fights. You can lose warships forever. Some of them will go to repair, you can repair them, but others in PvP they are lost and then they are gone. So instead of losing them, up to 16.2% can then be converted to repairs that you do not lose your power completely. Therefore, I do see this ship for sure in the campaign because of the flagship attack and the flagship damage reduction and flagship HP on skill 5, but also in PvP, the convert to damage might be very, very helpful for PvP. Poseidon and Theseus, warship HP, warship shield, warship armor. When attacking other commanders, so PvP again, warship attack, warship shield. When your fleet is above 70% HP, you get a huge warship armor boost. So overall, I see warship armor, warship shield, warship HP, warship shield, warship armor. As the skill 4 is conditional only when attacking other commanders, we are talking about PvP again, but with a huge boost in protection. So making your ships much more difficult to get killed. We do also have some ships that increase the damage. This one is mainly protective. I do like this that have to see how that works out, what later will turn out to be better damage or protection. Artemis and Orion, you will get warship armor and at the same time, red, you will lose warship range. So warship armor plus 162%, that's a huge boost. On the second one you get frigate armor and shield, frigate warship shield and then frigate speed and HP. This is a huge protection boost and mainly focused on frigates. So frigates also do have the highest armor ratio of all warships in game, giving them 162% plus 81% armor. That's huge. That's 243% additional armor. That's amazing. And then increasing the shield by another 160% and the HP by 40%. Wow, I'm really looking forward to get the Artemis or the Orion. Probably the Orion will be better for me because I will be able to buy more blueprints for the Orion and therefore get these skills up because I don't want to get stuck at 15%. I want to get these to the max as fast as possible. Achilles and Peleus, increase gather speed, increase warship attack, increase planet resource gathering, and increase warship HP. So we do have an unconditioned warship attack here up to 54%, an additional warship HP 40.5%. That's pretty nice. The other two skills are for gathering, and it's the only ship that increases your planet gathering. So, for sure, if you want to gather resources from planets, this is a ship to use, but at the same time, you do get some nice attack and HP bonus here, too. Cyclops and Brontos, you do get warship attack while losing warship shield. Thinking about frigates, they do have a very low shield, that seems to be nice, but then we do have the cruiser versus frigate bonus here, and the cruiser, or let me quickly double check that I didn't do a mistake there. Cyclops, yeah, cruiser attacks frigate bonus. That's very interesting because usually cruisers do have a malus against frigate. So if we take a look at the ships, if you look at cruisers, they have increased damage against destroyers and reduced damage by 15% against frigates. So with this flagship, you do get a boost of the damage from cruisers versus frigates, so you lose this malus. Okay, frigates still will have a bonus damaging your cruisers, but I mean, plus 54% is huge. You increase your cruiser attack and your cruiser HP by 32.4%. The total warship attack of all warships by 40.5%. And as long as your fleet is over 70%, you do get additional warship attack of another 54%. The enemy frigates should be blown out of the sky very easily with this setup. Get a few cruisers inside there. Get rid of this malus cruisers versus frigates. The cruisers already have a 50% bonus against destroyers. Then you add additional attack of 40.5%, 32.4% for the cruisers, and 54%. That will hurt. I want to get the Prontus because it's a version I can skill up. I can get the skills up faster. But I really look forward to get this ship. I want that. Hades and Radamantis. Warship speed. Not so sure about warship speed. I don't really see a big advantage there. Destroyer attack, destroyer HP, warship shield, and warship speed again. So your ships will get very quick. Destroyer range. Range, speed, speed. Not really sure if this will give you a huge advantage. If any of you out there already have some data, some trials, and know how much warship speed affects, like the performance, the damage, the whatever, please leave me a comment. I'm really looking forward to get your feedbacks there. Overall, this one is made for mainly destroyers, but I don't really like the skill combination, the skill sets of these two ships. Titan and Atlas, warship attack without condition, nice. Warship range, I think this is mainly good for like campaign, that you can stay behind the allied units and don't get the damage. When your fleet HP is below 50%, you get additional warship attack. And when attacking a commander, you do get additional warship attack and armor. So considering this warship HP 50% to get up to 67.5% warship attack, I try to think how to set up the fleet for this. First your frigates die, then your destroyers will die, then your flagship will die. That would mean I would try to set up like 50% of the fleet HP in cruisers, that as soon as my flagship dies, I really can put out a lot of damage. Yeah, attacking other commander, so it's PvP related. You will get a nice boost at the end. Can be surprising. Suddenly, yeah, getting up to 40.5% armor and attack. Might change the fight, but not my favorite skill setup. Odysseus and Apollo, leadership, we already talked about leadership. Increasing the versus bonus up to 27%. Both of these are nice, but not the strongest skills. Convert losses to damage up to 33.8%. This one is huge. This is 33.8%. Here we only had 16.2%. So this is big. And then increasing warship attack and armor by 54%. This one is PvP reducing losses. I'm not sure if there will be any PvE fights where you can lose warships. I did not encounter them. We had some losses, but this was a bug. And as far as I know, it's already fixed. So if I want to go big on PvP, probably the Odysseus will be the ship I will use to reduce the losses that I encounter there, and get like the maximum out of it, like farming. If I want to farm other players, the losses you get, they are always the biggest risk. If you attack another alliance, so you really have strong fleets versus each other, you would lose a lot of warships, you lose a lot of power at the end. So Odysseus might help you to stay on top of these losses and get out there like as a winner, and 33.8% is big. Okay, so I hope I was able to give you a nice overview of the flagships available out there. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. Leave me your feedback in the comments, and do me a favor, subscribe to the channel, make it visible to other players, and hope to see you on the next video. Enjoy the game.